Hi, my name's Joe, and I'm a third year construction management student within the School of Civil Engineering and Construction here at Kingston University. That school sits within the wider Faculty of Science, Engineering and Computing. A little bit about myself. I took a gap year before coming to university and worked on a building site. So that kind of gave me a foundation which I sort of springboarded from now. In terms of myself, I've done some course representation and I've also worked as a student ambassador whilst here at university in the first and second years. And I support Arsenal, think of that what you will, and I also am a member of the Recreational Badminton Society as well. So the first 2 years at university here for me on the construction management course obviously involved technical knowledge and developing that kind of skill base, so in terms of densities of concrete and types of contract and all those little things that obviously you learn, which are really important, but also almost more important, or at least as important, are the soft skills that you learn here at uni. The reason I say about those things and I talk about those things is because they're really important when it comes to getting out on site, particularly for a placement, and then obviously when you actually get out site when you graduate. And I'll obviously come back to those later on in the presentation. So I worked for a company called Mace Limited. They're an international construction and consultancy firm. They work in a wide range of areas: aviation, transport, commercial offices, arts and culture. The list is endless. They operate over 65 countries. They have over 3,000 employees. Their turnover in 2010 was 850 million. So certainly a large outfit within the construction industry. So I took a 12-month placement with Mace, and they put me on the British Museum World Conservation and Exhibitions Centre. And that was a 90 million-ish construction project. It was a construction management contract. And I got to the project on stage E, which is what we refer to as stage E. And that was basically where archaeology was on site and we hadn't even gone into the ground yet. When I left, it got to piling stage, and the actual project is due to run until August 2013. So it's about a 3 year project in total. So to obviously be involved in a project like that is a fantastic opportunity. Working for a client such as the British Museum is fantastic as well, because you get to deal with people who are world leaders really in their field, and the British Museum as an institution is a world leader in terms of conservation. Primarily my role was labelled a package manager. So what the team at the British Museum did was basically gave me a level of responsibility for over £1 million worth of preliminary packages. And primarily I was responsible for delivering the temporary accommodation package, which was in the region of £800,000, and I had to deliver that from procurement to delivery. And that involved essentially putting a three-storey temporary accommodation block on a 6-metre-high gantry over a road, which in itself was actually quite a difficult task. They gave me a lot of responsibility, and certainly decisions that I was making had very real effects if I didn't get them right, or I wasn't keeping my superiors informed every step of the way. I also then procured the scaffolding package as well, so that was in the region of £300,000. So I only took that to tender stage. But even so, I was preparing contract documents, organising drawings and preparing annexes, which were going to be used by the contractors to actually price the work. So, you know, for me, it was a very significant learning curve, and it was certainly a baptism of fire in places. But, you know, learnt a great deal, and certainly I can use that now in my final year as well. In terms of other things that we did on the year out, now this is specific to Mace, is that they offered a training scheme. So we went through various modules such as program management and contractual procedures, M&E, the list is quite a lot, but that's a fantastic way of networking with other placement students, other graduates with Mace. And at the end of the year, they did a large end of year event as well. And that was really fantastic. And that gave a different insight into areas that maybe I didn't have dealings with day to day on the actual job I was working on. Also, can't underestimate the value of networking. You obviously meet professionals in the industry throughout the whole time. I certainly made a lot of contacts out there, both within Mace and external to Mace as well. Architects, the client, contractors, other graduates, all that kind of stuff. And they can be fantastic when you're either in your final year, and for me, it helps me with my dissertation, for example. But equally, when you get out there after you graduate, it's fantastic to actually know professionals already when you actually get out there. Working for Mace, they work on a lot of projects throughout London. Notably, at the moment I was working for them, it was the Shard and the Olympics. And so I got the opportunity to go and visit those sites, which was a fantastic opportunity, which I probably wouldn't have got had I not have been working with Mace, particularly going to the Olympics and seeing such a vast site and getting behind the scenes there was a real opportunity as well. Going back to the soft skills that I mentioned at the beginning of the presentation about presentation and group work and all that kind of stuff, I feel that it helps to have a practical example really of how that helped me whilst I was out there in working for Mace in the real world really. So in terms of presentation, I had to represent Mace to Camden Council at a meeting, and that was in relation to the temporary accommodation that I was delivering, and that was quite a scary moment, but again, baptism of fire, you're out of your comfort zone, but it's a really fantastic way to learn and it really challenges you. Group work as well, you're part of a team. I was part of a team of about 20 throughout the time I was there. So you obviously bring your skills and abilities, and that then in theory complements the rest of the team. And so you've got to be able to get on with people from all different nationalities and speaking different languages and different opinions and attitudes. But again, university gives you that foundation to work from, particularly through the group work that we do throughout the course. Time management's important as well. I found that you couldn't really be late for meetings. You can sometimes get away with it here for lectures at university, but certainly when you're out on site, being late for meetings, unless there's a pretty valid excuse, is a bit of a no-go. And again, university can prepare you for that. Organisation and communication, being able to get information when it's asked. I was there for only a few months and already I had lever arches full of information on my desk. And so, being at university, having a lot of different assignments and different modules and loads of different information that's thrown at you, it's a really good way of getting into that organisation and kind of getting those skills honed for when you get out there, because you've got to know where all your information is, and that can really prepare you for that. Writing skills as well, you do a lot of reports here at uni, you do a lot of essays, and so being able to actually generate a professional looking report, both in structure and the way it's written, is really important. I must have generated probably 4 or 5 reports when I was there for various different things. And obviously you're preparing documentation that goes in front of the client or your manager or directors. So, you know, you've got to really improve and hone those skills while you're here at uni. And that can, again, set you up for when you get out there on a placement or when you graduate. So what are the benefits of a year out? Financial, obviously. Certainly 9 times out of 10, you'll get a salary for the year that you work. And obviously, if you maintain student overheads, then you can either save or spend and do what you want with it. So that's a really attractive thing. Professional development. Our courses are accredited here. I know that the construction management course is accredited by the ICE and the CIOB. And so when you get out there on site, you can use that to your advantage and actually start your continued professional development. And then when you get out there after you've graduated, it certainly reduces the amount of time that you can become a member of that relevant body. It's a break from study. So, you know, I don't think you can underestimate the fact that you've done 2 years of fairly hard work. And then not to say that when you go out on site, it isn't hard work, but it's a different it's a different mindset, it's a different attitude, and it's quite refreshing, really. Well, I certainly found it refreshing to go out there, have a break from study, and then come back in my final year. And then moving on from that, you can then use the knowledge that you gained out on site for your final year. And certainly I found that the work that I've done has been improved significantly from the knowledge that I learned whilst out on site and the ways that I can apply that information that I learned into the work that we do in the final year. And also it can help you discern where you want to go after you've finished. You may want to do further education, you might want to go to a master's or something else. You may want to go abroad if you've got that opportunity. You may want to go into consultancy, or you may want to, you know, go and stay in delivery, or wherever you end up. I don't think you, again, you can't underestimate the fact that it'll help you discern and help you give a better idea, really, of where you want to go and where you're aiming to be. So I hope that was informative, and look forward to seeing you at an open day soon.